All right, my name is Dominic, and I'm going to be talking about music format and MP3s. So basically, MP3 is the format that we all know and love. It's what we carry in our pockets, what we have on our computers in the thousands or tens of thousands, and even stream them as we're going about our activities. However, there's various points that point to my main claim, which is that the MP3 as a format for music harms the experience of listening to our music. And I'm going to talk about that in three main ways. Firstly, is that MP3s produce low quality music due to the fact that they are all compressed forms of the music. And secondly, most of the products that we use to reproduce the music are not designed for high resolution listening. And thirdly, MP3s, because they can be bought individually, song per song, they place less value on the album as a complete work from a band or an artist. So back to my first point, that MP3s are low quality. The reason is because they are compressed. They, from the master files that an artist or a band records, it is continually trimmed down to a form that we can all easily access. And that's basically because we want them to be portable. We want to be able to fit thousands of them in our pockets. And just some statistics or some factual information regarding the actual information that's what we're listening to. iTunes is the amount sample rate is 256 kilobits per second. So what that means, that's the quantity of how much information we're receiving per second when we're listening to that audio. And in comparison to CD on average is 400 kilobits per second. And high resolution audio formats such as FLAC or DAD, which are other digital files, are typically over 3,000 kilobits. So compared to other types of audio, MP3s dwarf in comparison. And because of that, a lot of information is cut out. For example, the highs and the lows, which is a result of dynamic range compression, and that takes out the treble and the bass. And so that's the clarity of a voice or the deep bass from a bass drum or a bass guitar. And we can't fully process the information that we're listening to. We don't have the full effect of what has actually been recorded. And ultimately, we are not receiving the same information that has been recorded in the studio. And Neil Young, who is a famous rock musician, has been quoted saying, "We live in the digital age, and unfortunately, it's degrading our music and not improving it." And to my second point, which also backs up how MP3 is not improving our listening experience, is that the methods we use to reproduce that are not designed to support high quality listening. For example, computers and the speakers that are put into them are not designed for high resolution music. It's further the degradation of what we're listening to. So you're basically taking a compressed file, and then when listening to them on your computer, the computer speakers are not designed to be able to transmit all the frequencies that are on those files. And also, the earbuds that we listen to when we're walking around and whatnot, they're nearly not capable enough to produce all the sounds, even within an MP3 file, and therefore, it's a further degradation of that music format. And to my third point, because MP3s can be bought on an individual scale, song per song, that's great when you want to get to the hits and whatnot. However, it places less value on the album. So we can't experience the complete work of an artist in which they ultimately have put forth for something that's intended to be experienced as one complete artwork. And George Eratrudis, who is the head of music at BBC Radio 1, has been quoted saying that most people are not listening to albums. They are flicking through your playlists, particularly if you are talking about mass market artists. We are now in a singles-based culture, which is very, very true. Most of us listen to a lot of playlists where you're listening to one artist and then the other. And it's basically comparable to watching only one scene from a movie. It's only taking a small bite out of an entire work, and that may be a very good piece, it may be a song that you really like, but ultimately it is something that you don't garner the full experience from, because you're not in relation to what the artist has put forth for you to experience. So in conclusion, because of MP3's low quality format, and that we are receiving much less information on an audio level from what has been recorded from the studio, and also because of the way that most people reproduce them and how technology is used to listen to music, and lastly because album sales are low and that most people don't listen to complete albums, those are the reasons why that MP3 as a format for music harms the experience of listening to our music.
All right, I'm going to start in the middle on this one because I think that's where the big problem in the speech is. On the second point, when you talk about the media that people use to listen to music, there's like no evidence on this point at all. It's an assertion on your point, and I have no idea, not being an audiophile, I have no idea what the difference is between the speakers on the computer and the speakers that are designed for high-resolution listening, or that the kinds of things that people might have on their television sets or in their stereo systems, what's substantially different about them. You know, the average listener, are they going to be able to detect those kinds of things? I'm not saying that you're not correct on this, I'm just saying that you need to document it on these particular points, and I didn't really think that that was documented. The earbuds especially, I think most people, you know, they're not sitting down listening to the music in the, you know, aural environment where they're absorbing it. They're out jogging, or they're listening to the music while they're cooking or something like that. And so there's something, I think, a little bit different about that. I do think that you're right in that there's been a change in the way people process music as a result of the change in the technology. I think that that may be something that could be developed a little bit more, but I think you're going to need to find some more data on that. That last point is on the brink of making that same argument, but it's also on the brink of being a value claim, suggesting that that is a better way to listen to music. For example, so it's become a singles industry as opposed to an album industry. Well, the description of what's lost from the album experience is really vague. You've got an analogy on that point. I kind of like the analogy, except that I'm not sure how well it works, and I think you need some particular examples to illustrate that point. If you've got an example of music that people listen to where they only pay attention to one of the songs and they don't pay attention to the rest of the album, and they're missing something that's so particular, important, valuable, you know, I don't know what that is. You know, it's one of those things where I think, well, you know, so the Bruno Mars hits, if I actually listened to the whole album, I'd get a story, or I'd get a feeling, or I'd have a theme that's going on there. But I don't know that that's the case, and that's, I think, what's missing on that third point. On the other hand, those are the things that I think are problematic. On the other hand, I thought you did a pretty good job at the beginning turning what looked like it was going to be a value argument into a claim of fact, except for that third point where I think you kind of fall off of that tightrope a little bit. It's very well organized. Some of the information that you present on the first point, you've got data on the kilobits per second. Was it kilobits? Okay, kilobits per second. I thought that was pretty good, except again, you know, how much can people perceive on that? How different is it? That sounds pretty dramatic when you're talking about a difference between 250 kilobits per second and potentially 4,000 kilobits per second. All right, and you kind of describe the dynamic range that gets lost. Is there any way that we could understand that without listening to music? That's the problem. I think some of what you're describing is really a little esoteric. I thought you did a really nice job, kind of like I said to David before, you did a nice job speaking to the audience and looking at us and selling yourself as a convincing advocate for the position that you have. Thank you.